Hello, boys and girls. Before we get carried away, let's get into the reality of things. When I received this wig, it was like this. In fact, when the company approached me, I was the one who chose it in this platinum blonde because I was trying to try the watercolor method for you guys for the first time. So I was like, okay, let's take this hair. So to color the hair, I use the Inecto hair dye, Brazen Brown. And this is the wrong dye for the experts that actually told me on Instagram. Thank you for telling me. This was the wrong dye that I actually used. So first things first, what I did was squeeze out the dye from the tube, obviously, and I had to mix it with the peroxide because when the dye comes, it comes in the tube as well as the peroxide. So you need to mix it in order to develop the color. If you don't do that, the color is not going to develop. And I had to put it in warm look water, and as I was putting it, guess what guys, the dye started turning purple. And this is when I realized that I was probably headed for the worst and I was doing something that was probably not going to be fruitful. But I went ahead and I added the dye to the mixture, and when I added it, it was clumpy, obviously, because it's not meant to be used like this. This was all trial and error. So I took my cooking spoon. I was like, I'm not gonna stop now since I've already started. And I mixed the dye. The next thing that I did was add the wig, and the color was not developing on the wig instantly. And that's when I sort of realized that I had actually done like a really big mistake. So I didn't give up though. I kept on forcing the wig into the lukewarm water and the dye, and I was turning it. It's like literally cooking the wig, guys. That's what I was doing. And please don't use your hands like I was doing. Try to wear your gloves so that you can protect your hands, because peroxide and dye will burn your hands. So I waited 5 minutes like the Americans do, you know, like when they dye their wigs, the professionals, they wait for like 5 minutes or 10 minutes and their hair is like it's dyed. But to my surprise, I waited for 5 minutes and my wig was still looking blonde. So what I did was I left my wig for like 5 hours. At this point in time, I was just hoping that the dye wasn't going to destroy my hair. And to tell you guys, this is such good quality hair. I left it for 5 hours, and when I took it out, it was still intact. It did not shed a bit, and when I say a bit, it didn't shed at all. So I was really happy that the hair didn't budge, didn't get destroyed in the process. So after that, I just took it out and I washed it, obviously, and ironed it and prepped it. I really like this hair, guys. Like, I won't lie to you, this is not my first platinum blonde. I've shared on my stories before, I've received countless wigs from companies that are platinum, and I didn't try the watercolor method on them. I tried dyeing them like just directly with the dye, and they didn't hold up. They were shedding, and I ended up not having to review them because I was not happy with the quality of the hair. But this particular blonde was such good quality, so much that even after I dyed it, after I did all the stuff that I did to it, ironed it, it still held up, guys. It's a full wig, and for the price that it comes at, I would say it's really, really worth it. Like, platinum blondes are really expensive because there's a lot of process that goes into actually making it platinum like it is. But this wig, definitely thebomb.com. And I just went ahead and I started ironing my hair. As you can see, that because I'm an amateur and I was doing this for the first time, you can see that some of the hair wasn't dyed properly. You can see that some strands are lighter than the rest, but I think I actually like how it came out like that, because I think if it was all brown and all brazen, it wasn't gonna look quite nice on my skin tone. So I just went ahead and I started ironing the hair, straightening it, because I wanted it like super straight, not in a wavy form. Open eye, feel the waves cut through. So if you want that curvy look at on the ends of the hair, what you want to do is you want to twist your flat iron at the end, like when you get to the end strands of the hair, you want to twist your flat iron so that the hair is curly at the end. So you can see there, it's done. I really hate that little dot in front of the hair that was turning darker than the rest of the hair. It really freaks me out. I think I'm gonna try and bleach it and dye it again, because I absolutely hate it. And what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna cut the lace. I've already done a video on how to cut your lace in detail. I'm just gonna put it right up here, and I am putting on the mousse just so that I can cut the lace. I've explained it step by step in the video that's on your right hand or on your left hand. Just go and check it out if you do want to know how to cut your lace in detail. It's really gonna help you out.
I know you feel like you want me, and I guess in a way you do. Holding my breath, unraveling emotions. I need some space to think this through. Call me on now. The pain is in my eyes. Feels like I could break at any moment and shatter your insides. If you read my mind, call me on now.
So as per usual, all the information about the hair is going to be in the description box. You will find all the information that you need about the hair in the description box. I obviously went and I cut this wig. I also cut the lace frontal and the baby hairs, just so to create this illusion, because I kind of felt like I could see the lace. The lace was really transparent, so I had to I had to hide the lace frontal with the baby hairs. If it wasn't for that matter that I could see the lace, I wasn't gonna do the baby hairs. But baby hairs are optional, guys. Not everyone likes them. Sometimes I like them. I like the look on my other wigs. Sometimes I don't. And I just went ahead and I tied my hair at the back and cut it. This method really works if you're not a pro, if you're someone that doesn't know how to cut hair. You can do this, but also you're gonna need assistance with someone to help you with the back, to just help you keep the hair in symmetry, or yeah, if that makes sense. So yeah, I just went ahead and I cut the hair and I flat ironed it once more. And I don't wanna fight with you, I would rather lie to you. I promise now's not the right time. And I don't wanna fight with you.